Welcome to this Christmas Eve service of carols, communion, and candlelight as we celebrate the birth of Jesus, our Savior. We thank the many participants in this special service, readers, choirs, musicians, staff, ushers, setup and cleanup folks. All your contributions are greatly appreciated. And all those who help decorate and donate poinsettias to make the sanctuary so beautiful. All the readings and carols are in your bulletin. Responses printed in dark bold print are to be said by all. An asterisk indicates to stand as able. At candle lighting time, please always hold a lit candle upright to prevent dripping hot wax and only tilt the unlit candle to the flame. Keep the flame at a safe distance from others and monitor children so we all can enjoy this beautiful moment. Review all the announcements at the end of your bulletin. All are welcome to Christmas Day service tomorrow and following Sunday services at 10:30 a.m. I have a prayer list here that includes Pastor John. We're thankful Pastor is here as we know his strength, stamina, and voice can be greatly affected by the immunotherapy cancer treatments he is receiving. In addition, on the prayer list, are there any other joys or concerns that you would like to include in our time of prayer later in this service? Then we will begin our service, and you are invited to stand as you are able for the ringing of the bell.
Please join in the call to worship. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, love from the beginning, word made flesh, breath of heaven. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth. Alleluia. God with us, Emmanuel, comes to us to give a holy family within the church as the body of Christ. Rejoice and be glad. Amen. On this holy night, we reflect on all that separates us from the love of God. Let us release our burdens to God, who has promised to hear and to give us another chance to live with love in our thoughts and deeds. Amen. Let us say together our prayer of confession. Heavenly Father, even tonight, children are being born for whom there is no place, whose lives are blighted from the beginning, from lack of love, nourishment, and shelter. Forgive us that too often there is no place in our lives for your Son. Let him be born again in us tonight, so that the hope, peace, joy, and love that he brings may not be homeless, but find an abiding place in our lives. Amen.
He comes with forgiveness. He comes with healing. He comes with faith, hope, and love. He comes to be at home with us forever.
And the Word became flesh and lived among us. And we have seen his glory, the glory of the Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. Amen.
We'll sing the opening carol, O Come All Ye Faithful.
Thank you.
seated. We'll continue with the lighting of the Advent wreath and the Christ candle. Over the past four Sundays of Advent, we lit the candles of hope, peace, joy, and love. As we light the Christ candle, celebrating the arrival of Christ and Christmas, let us remember how our Savior came as a lowly baby, so that through him the world might be saved, and that he will return one day in glory. Jesus said, "I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life." We'll sing "Hark the Herald Angels Sing." Children may come up. The children's choir.
Thank you. it, or do you want to just stand at it?
I feel like I should sing, but you really don't want me to do that with this microphone in front of me. Today we're going to talk about candy canes and how candy canes are connected to Christmas. Did you know that candy canes were connected to Christmas?
Kind of.
Oh my goodness. We're going to hear the story.
This gentleman here has a candy cane.
You do. That's a perfect candy cane tie. I love it. It goes along with the message. Okay, well, I'm going to tell you the history about the candy cane, even though you all know it, apparently.
Okay.
Oh, good.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
There you go.
Can everybody hear me now? Okay, thank you. Okay, so a long time ago in the olden days, there was a candy maker. And he wanted to make a piece of candy that would symbolize Christmas and the meaning of Christmas. So what's the meaning of Christmas?
Christ our Savior,
Jesus Christ, thank you.
But also, can we keep these?
Yes, you can keep them. I'll even give you another one.
Second question.
Priorities. So, what the candy maker did was he had to decide what shape he wanted to make the candy. That was the first decision that he made. So he decided to make the candy like this. I mean, most of us hold the candy canes like this, right? But what does it look like when it's like this?
A U.
A U? It looks like a J.
A capital J, but without.
Yes, it looks like a J. And what is a J in Jesus' name? Is there a J in Jesus' name?
Yes.
And where is it?
In the beginning of his name.
The first letter of Jesus' name starts with a J. Right? It's a J. The second decision that the candy maker had to make was what color should the candy be?
It was red and white.
Well, you're close. It actually was white. It started out just being white. And white was for the purity of Jesus Christ because he was out without sin. He was pure. And the white symbolized the purity of Jesus Christ. So then he thought, okay, well, that was pretty good, but I wanted to have some more color. So he decided to add the red stripes. And the red stripes symbolize the blood that was shed by Jesus when he went to the cross and took away our sins. And that's how we have the candy cane. That's what the candy cane means today. So now when you look at the candy cane, you can think about what the real meaning of Christmas is. Okay? Now, can we have a little prayer? And you'll repeat after me. Let's bow our heads. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for the birth of your Son, Jesus Christ. Thank you for this beautiful day of Christmas Eve. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
As God has given to us, all that we have is the Lord's. All that we may become and receive is in God's hands. Let us give generously for the well-being of the world. Let us pray for God's blessing on all our offerings. Emmanuel, God with us, you came as a baby to a manger. You slept on straw and greeted shepherds. Remind us how good you are at blessing ordinary things. Through these gifts, help us to bless the lives of others in your holy name. Amen. Please be seated. The Old Testament reading is from Isaiah chapter 9, verses 2 and 6. The Lord said to Isaiah, "The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who dwelt in the land of deep darkness, on them has light shined. For unto us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder, and his name will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace." This is the end of the Old Testament reading. The Gospel reading is from Luke chapter 2, verses 1 through 7. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration, and it was taken while Quirinius was the governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them at the inn. The reading continues from Luke chapter 2, verses 8 through 14. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." This is the good news for all people. Please stand as we sing, "Angels We Have Heard on High."
Good to see you all on this very lovely and cold Christmas Eve. I offer you a story tonight, but I must begin by saying that this is not my story. This is the story of a dear friend of mine, Jung Ray Chung. When I first started seminary, Jung Ray was the associate pastor at my home church and became my friend and mentor and friend of many, many years. And one day I had to deliver some things over to her house from the church, and I went into the kitchen and there was a display of poinsettias larger than I have ever seen. They were all in one pot. It was about like that in one pot. Now, Jung Ray had as much Christmas spirit as anyone, but she would have never bought one poinsettia, much less a display that looked like that. She bought her clothes at our used clothing store at the church, the Gleaners, and she bought pieces that might have been 20 or 30 years old that she figured might last another 20 or 30. So the idea of her paying an extravagant amount of money for these poinsettias, I was just floored. I said, "Jung Ray, have you lost your mind?" And she said, "Get a cup of coffee and sit down, and I'm going to tell you a story." And this is the story that she told me. When she and her husband first went into ministry, they went to school, to seminary, at Methesco Seminary. They were Korean, and they moved from Korea to Central Ohio to go to seminary. And they went to the little Methodist school, Methesco. It's in Delaware, Ohio, just north of Columbus. But it's a very small town. It's like one nice main street. And she and her husband were in school and trying to make ends meet. But they also really already had such a heart for ministry that they rented a little downtown storefront. Delaware was very poor, so it wasn't like there was nothing available. There were plenty available. And so they got this little storefront, and it had an apartment upstairs where they lived. And what they did in the downstairs was they had church services, they did feeding of people who were hungry, they tried to help the homeless, and they really reached out to a small but neglected Korean-speaking community in that area. So on a particular Christmas Eve, it would have been probably at least 25 years ago by now, this is the story that happened. So I have to give you some backstory first. She said that after they had been there about a year, they got a flyer with a picture from a Korean church in Chicago. And on the flyer was a picture of a teenage girl. And underneath the picture, it said, "Our daughter is lost. Our daughter is missing. Please pray for our daughter." And so these messages were sent out to a whole host of these little Korean churches all around. They have a really nice network. And so Jung Rae said she took that and she called the people who had, the mother who had sent the flyer. And it turned out that this young woman was very, very bright, and her family had immigrated from Korea at much expense to the whole rest of the family. And there was a real expectation on this young woman that she would do very, very well, and that she would be able to then generate some income and help others in her family, her extended family, be able to come. And so much pressure was put on her, however, that she just couldn't stand it any longer. And her parents wouldn't relent, and one day she just packed a few things in her backpack, and she left a note that said, "This is too hard for me. Don't worry about me." And she left. The first poster came. The first prayer request came. Excuse me. The next month, another one came. The next month, another one came. And I said, "Jung Rae, were you praying?" And she said, "Of course we were praying. Of course we were praying. Her picture was in my office. Her poster was in Jun Su's office. We prayed every single day. Our church prayed every time they got together. The members of the congregation." Thank you. "We prayed and we prayed and we prayed." Now, that in itself was pretty good as far as I was concerned, because I grew up in church circles where a lot of times we would get a prayer list and it would be on the back of the bulletin. And it would just be names, and so many of the needs, I mean, were lost to memory. And sometimes you just kind of got tired of praying for those same things and kind of let it go. I'm sorry to say that, but that's true. But she said, "We prayed. We prayed." And this went on for more than a year. She looked at that picture of that girl every day, and she prayed. And on that Christmas Eve, after their service, she was cleaning up, sweeping the floor, and she looked up, and at the back door was this girl. She said she really didn't know what to do. She didn't know what to do, but she was very wise. So she invited her to come in, and she said, "What can I do to help you?" And this young woman said, "I saw that you were Korean. I am Korean. I'm very hungry. I'll work if you can give me something to eat." And Jung Ray says, "Take this broom and start sweeping, and I will fix you something to eat." So after a while, Jung Ray got her settled down, and she fed her, and she just waited. And after a few minutes, the girl began to tell her story. And Jung Ray said, "Will you please just call your mother? You don't have to say where you are. Just say you're okay." And the girl agreed to do that. And Jung Ray knew, of course, once this little girl got on the phone with her mother, she broke down and cried and said, "Please come and get me." And I apologize. I'm having trouble tonight. I was out too long today. So they settled down to wait for the parents to arrive from Chicago to the middle of Ohio. And the little girl went to sleep on the couch, and Jung Ray went to sleep in the chair. And a couple of hours later, Jung Ray was awakened. Now, it wasn't the prancing and pawing of each little hoof, but it was a big racket in the back alley parking lot. And she heard these voices and this noise and this loud noises, and on there was a knock on the door. And she went to the door and opened the door, and here were four people she'd never seen before. And they said, "We're from Cincinnati. And we heard the daughter was found. And we've been praying for her, so we came to see for ourselves. We brought food." So Jung Ray said, "Come on in." They didn't know this girl. They didn't know Jung Ray. Little while later, knock, knock, knock. "We're from Louisville. We're from Indiana. We're from Pennsylvania." People just kept coming. They didn't know the girl. They didn't know each other. They had prayed, and when they heard the daughter was found, they were so thrilled that even though it was Christmas Eve, they got in their cars and they drove to Jung Ray's house. And before the night was over, they were feasting and they were having a prayer meeting and they were singing and they were praising, and there were over 70 people in that little apartment from 7 different states. Jung Ray said, "You see those poinsettias? I get one of those every year from her mother." The bond of the Christian community has so much power. It has so much strength. And so often it's wasted because of fighting or disagreement. But we're missing so much. I think that is just the most powerful example of the body of Christ, I believe, that I've any story I've ever heard. And so I offer you that story for this Christmas Eve. Thank you.
Jesus said, "Come to me, all you who are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light." Let us stand, O little town of Bethlehem. Let us pray. Gracious God, we thank you for gathering us together on this Christmas Eve. We ask that you might be with us this evening and into Christmas Day. We ask that you might help us to bring the love of Jesus Christ into this world, into our families, with our friends, to be people who bring kindness and gentleness, generosity, a spirit of love to all whom we meet and know and reach out to. Let us be a people who, as disciples of Jesus Christ, bring Jesus' way of love into the world. Let us pray as Jesus taught us the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive our sins. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. This table is for all Christians who wish to know the presence of Christ and to share in the community of God's people. God be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to God Most High. It is truly right and our greatest joy to give you thanks and praise, O holy God, creator and ruler of the universe. For you came in silence while all lay sleeping, to enter our world as a child of humble birth. We thank you for your Son, Jesus Christ, born of Mary. In his face we behold your glory, for in his life, as in his death, is our gift of salvation. We remember on the night of betrayal and desertion, and on the eve of death, Jesus gathered the disciples for the feast of Passover. Jesus took bread and after giving thanks to you, broke it and gave it to the disciples, saying, "This is my body broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, also the cup after supper, saying, "This is the cup of is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Remembering your gracious acts in Jesus Christ, we take from your creation this bread and this wine and joyfully celebrate Christ dying and rising as we await the day of his coming. Gracious God, pour out your Holy Spirit upon us and make our hearts burn with thanksgiving that we may give as we have received. Let our whole lives be gifts of praise to you, God of love and peace. In the gracious name of Jesus Christ, your Son, by the power of your Holy Spirit, now and forever. Through Christ, with Christ, in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor be to you, Almighty God, now and forever. Amen. The bread which we break is the communion of the body of Christ. The cup of blessing which we bless is the communion of the blood of Christ. Love has come, God's love for all people. Come and eat, for Christ invites you. The body of Christ broken for you, take and eat. Cup of salvation poured out for you, take and drink. Let us join together in the post-communion prayer. Great and saving God, you have gathered your scattered people around the gift of grain and wine, the body and blood of our Savior Christ. As we, like the shepherds, return on our way, may we proclaim all we have seen, praising you in word and loving deed, for the gift of Jesus, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
We'll continue in your bulletin with the candle lighting. Please join in the candle lighting and responsive reading. God's light goes on shining in the darkness. and the darkness has never understood it. God's light goes on shining in the darkness, and the darkness has never put it out. Have all received the light? Then please stand and sing Silent Night in your bulletin.
Thank you.
Please carefully extinguish your candles, holding them upright until the wax is hardened. We'll continue in the bulletin with the commission to serve.
When the song of the angels is stilled, when the star in the sky is gone, when the kings and princes are home, when the shepherds are back with their flock, the work of Christmas begins. To find the lost, to heal the broken, to feed the hungry, to release the prisoner, to rebuild the nations, to bring peace among people, to make music in the heart. Go in peace, serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Joy to the world.